Today in this video, we will be discussing the convolutional neural network that is prominently used to deal with images, because since the last 3 to 4 videos, we are using deep neural networks and saw how great potential they have to approximate data. But the only thing they lack is dealing with images. If you give them images of football in this configuration, but during the prediction time, if you give an image of a football like this, they won't be able to classify it. This means ANNs are sensitive to the location of an object. This issue was solved by convolutional neural networks. But before learning about it, we have to look at how image data really looks like. This image of 4 you are looking at now is made from 28 by 28 array of pixels, and each pixel is a value deciding its color. 0 means pure black and 255 means pure white, and each pixel you see is some value between the range 0 to 255, making this image of 4. To give this image of 4 to an ANN, we will have to flatten this image, making a 1D array of 784 values. On just a small image of 28 by 28 pixels, we have an array of 784 values. Now just imagine, when you have to deal with 1080p images, the image you are currently seeing is 1080p. It has a size of 1080 by 1920 pixels. And if you have to flatten this thing, it will give us a gigantic 1D array of size 2,073,600. Giving this to DNN would be a complete destruction. That's why convolutional neural networks came into existence. First off, neural networks cannot deal with the image in its raw form. First, we have to convert it into an array. As I said, each pixel is a value between 0 to 255, and then we can run the convolution operation on this array. But for simplicity's sake, I will show this array in image form. The most important thing in CNN is the kernel or filter, which is used to extract features from this image, like edges, colors, and other abstract shapes. In this image, you can see there are 16 various filters, and their primary work is to find patterns in the image. If we apply this filter to our input image, we will get this feature map. You can see pattern extracted by filters, like here the image is a little shallow. Here it has given more importance to the tail of 9. And when all these patterns come together, CNN can smartly deal with image datasets. But how CNN is finding these patterns? Firstly, it randomly initializes this filter, and as the training proceeds, it tries to find values that can make good feature maps. If we have good feature maps, it will ultimately make CNN better in dealing with images. The filter is like a sliding window that will convolve the entire image. Currently, the size of our filter is 3x3, so it will go to the start of our image and hover over it. So the part it is hovering is known as a window. To revise, this is our filter or kernel matrix, and this is the window over which our filter is hovering, and the star mark means we are doing an element wise multiplication and summing the entire matrix. If we calculate the answer, we will get 0, and this 0 is nothing but the first pixel of our feature map. And then we will do this repeatedly by moving our filter by 1 to the right. As soon as the end of the image is reached, it will move down by 1 and start convoluting again. After completing the convolution operation, the image you are seeing now is the feature map or the pattern extracted by our filter. You can see this is a horizontal filter. It has given more importance to the pixels which are horizontally aligned and less importance to the vertical pixels. Doing this convolution operation with TensorFlow is easy. First, I've imported an image with the pillow library. This image of the house is our input image, and then we can specify a kernel matrix. I've done some reshaping according to TensorFlow's requirements, and then we can give the image array and kernel to the tf.nn.conv2d function, which will do convolution operation for us. You can also specify strides and padding. Padding is not covered in this video. I may create a separate video on it, and we will learn about strides in a moment. And then if I plot the feature map, it has given us this image. It kind of looks like a horror house. We can see different feature maps by randomly creating a kernel matrix. In this image, it looks like the house is on fire. So the primary work of the kernel matrix is to find some hidden patterns in the image and then exploit these patterns for our purpose, like classifying images. You can also see that the feature map has fewer dimensions compared to the input image. You can calculate the output height and width by this formula. But what is the stride? Stride is the value by which we are moving this filter. Previously we moved this by 1 to the right, means the stride is equal to 1. If we make it 2, then the filter will move 2 steps to the right at a time. This will make the image size even smaller. Now it is 13 by 13. Making strides equal to 3 will make it 9 by 9. In Keras, first I have created a 28 by 28 random array and then given it to the Keras conv2d layer with various strides. If I plot this, you can see how the size of the image is decreasing with every value of strides. If I do the same with the home image, which was 333 by 500, now with every new value of stride, it is getting reduced. This is what CNN does, reducing the size of the image without losing much information. As you can see, this home is in the extreme right. Even if the dimensions are getting reduced, it is still there and does not get cropped. Now when you know about convolution operation and strides, it's time to visit one more important concept in CNN, which is max pooling. Even though CNN is reducing the dimensions of the image, it is sometimes still too large. That's why we use max pooling to downscale the image size even more. Currently, all the pixels in this window are 0. So first, we will calculate the maximum from all of them, which is of course 0. That's why this will be the output of the max pooling. But let's choose a window in which there are pixels of different values. Yeah, in this the pixel with maximum value is 253. The one which is highlighted with yellow is the output of max pooling. And this will happen repeatedly till the end. You can provide pool size to be any number of your choice. Currently, it is 3x3. You can do max pooling with Keras by this class, in which you can specify the pool size and strides of your choice. I've done it with various values. When stride is equal to 1, you cannot even tell that this image is max pooled. But when the stride is equal to 3, the image gets a little distorted, but still you can tell this image is of a house. Then you can see the image with various pool sizes. With a pool size equal to 6 and stride equal to 3, the image gets downscaled to 110 by 165, which is half of the actual image. But still, the amount of information remains the same. Just a little blurriness. To stitch everything we learned, we start with an input image and then we did the convolution operation, which will give us feature maps. In the earlier example, we only selected one filter, but in reality, you can choose many filters, which will give that many amounts of feature maps. After this, we do max pooling, which downscales feature map, and then we can do convolution operation again. If you are dealing with problems like classifying images of cats and dogs, only one layer of convolution is not enough. So you have to do convolution and max pooling again to extract high-level features. After this, we will flatten our final feature maps and give them to a neural network. We do this because CNN only does the work of extracting patterns from the image. It cannot tell whether an image is of a dog or cat, but it can extract patterns that differentiate images of dogs and cats. That's why we give these feature maps to the neural network, and which does the final work of classifying images. In short, they both work in coordination. Now, the last layer of the neural network has 9 neurons because it has to classify digits from 0 to 9. So we can apply a softmax activation and it will tell the most likely digit are input images. The entire thing you just saw was a single forward pass in a convolutional neural network. In backward pass, trainable parameters like filters and biases are updated, and this thing happens repeatedly to increase the accuracy and to decrease the loss function. Maybe in one of the future videos, I will tell how backward pass in convolutional neural network happens. So that's it for today's video. Till next time, see my other videos, and if you are from the very future, I may have already uploaded many videos in this series. So you can get the playlist link in the description and many other useful resources. See you in the next video.